Hokidemi, shaping professionals for a better future.
Hello everyone, welcome to Hokidemi. Now, this will be a lecture series consisting of total 5 videos in which we will discuss in very detail about the different types of mega projects, the teams involved in it, and what different roles, functions and responsibilities all the members of these teams carry out. So, if we talk about a medium scale project or a small scale project, then the standard structure of the bifurcation of these teams is mainly divided into 5 categories, which will be first the client team or the PMC team. The second will be the architect and interior designers team. The third will be the engineering design consultant team. The fourth will be the contractor team. And lastly, we have the supplier or vendor team. Now, all of these teams will work in coordination with each other during the different stages of the entire project or during the entire run of the project, and they will work in harmony and coordinate with each other at different successive points in that project. Now, if we talk about the large scale projects, then these 5 teams are condensed into a 3 team structure. So firstly, we have the client team as usual, then the architects and designers team. Now the rest of the 3 teams, that is the engineering consulting team, the contractor team and the supplier vendor team, they will act as one team called a EPC unit, the engineering procurement construction team. And we have examples for that like L&T, then Tata Consultancy and Engineering Services. So these are the examples of EPC firms. So these will be the structure in very high scale or mega scale or large scale projects. Now, there are various kinds of roles and functions that all these teams perform, like financing, auditing, licensing. Then we have the purchasing of different equipments, their installation, the designing of entire project, and the designing also includes the conceptual plans. Then we have the engineering design. In engineering also there are many more bifurcations inside it. Then we have the different supply, installation, testing and commissioning of different kinds of equipments, machineries, etc. We have the different execution of services. Then the contractors will come in at different stages. Then we'll have the handing over or commissioning of the project or any kind of service. So all these functions have to be performed at a specific time in the project. And we will discuss in detail in these upcoming 5 videos that which task has to be performed at which point of time, who will perform it, and what are the data needed in order to do that task efficiently and on time within the given cost of the project.
Hokidemi, shaping professionals for a better future.
Project team roles of different contracting companies. Now, what is the main role of a contracting company? I think it is very known to all of you. The contracting company has the main role of executing the different designs that are provided by the engineering consultants and the architects, and they are bound to follow all the protocols, specifications and the different types of quality of materials and services that are provided by the client, architect as well as the engineering consultant, and execute the work in the given time frame and within the definitive cost. So this is the scope of work of a contracting company. Now, as you can see, the contracting company or contractors team can be divided into 5 categories again. Firstly, we have the project coordinators. Now, the project coordinators will be from the each and every engineering faculty we saw earlier. Then we have the site engineers team that will be mainly for civil, mechanical and electrical engineering. Third category, we have the billing engineering team. Fourth is the purchase or contract engineers. And lastly, we have a team of the supporting staff, that is the site supervisors, technicians and storekeepers. Now we'll understand in detail about all the categories. This is the fourth category of the entire mega project team role that we are studying. Okay, so going further into detail, firstly, we have the contracting company site engineer's role. Now, it is very clear from the name itself that the site engineer's posting will be done mainly on the site. They will just be coordinating with their project coordinator or project manager, depending upon the type of the project. Now, what are the roles and responsibilities of a site engineer from a contracting company? So, first and foremost is the execution of the work as per drawing. Now, this site engineer can be of any field, that is civil, mechanical, or electrical. They will execute the work given by the consultant or architect as per the given technical specifications and as per the norms that are provided by the government. Okay. Next, we have the testing of materials received. Now, testing of materials is mainly done in the civil side of the engineering team. Different types of tests are performed, say cube test or bar test, rebar test, and also some materials are tested for the electrical engineers, that is the type of cable, VC, not exactly tested, they are just verified. So the site engineer's role is to test the quality of the materials received and see that they match the given specifications or not. Okay. Then we have the manpower and material arrangement and store management. Now, this is a very crucial role for a site engineer, the manpower and material management. So now, as we all know, the site work does not have a definite time. Depending upon the urgency of the project or the stage of the project, this can be done in the early mornings and till late nights. So the site engineer has to coordinate with all the corporate teams or the project coordinator, so that the manpower that he has arranged does not sit idly at any point of time, and they give their maximum output. Also, they need to coordinate with the store managers in order to plan the different materials that will be needed at the site. Say, for example, some material is needed, and if proper planning is not done and the site work is going on till midnight, then the purchase team will have gone. Then the purchase team will already have left by noon, as they are in the corporate side of the project. So it is the site engineer's role to arrange that material in advance. Okay. Then we have the installation, testing, and commissioning (ITC) of different equipments. We have discussed this in detail in the previous videos for the engineering consultants as well as the PMC team for the client. That ITC is a job which involves the client's team, site engineer, the engineering consultant, design project coordinator as well, and finally the site engineer from the contracting company. So the installation part is done completely by the contractor site engineer. So it can be any kind of equipment or any kind of machinery that is to be installed during the project. Then the testing and commissioning is mainly done by the vendor and supplier engineers. So they show how the machine works. They mainly educate the client team as well as the contracting team. And finally, upon test, they commission or hand it over to the client as well as the contractor. Okay. Then we have MOM, different test reports, measurement, then JMR and billing. Now, MOM, the minutes of meeting, are recorded. Generally, this is the trend that we see in this country, that weekly site meetings are done. So during the site meeting, the client site engineer is present, the engineering consultant is sometimes present, or someone from their team is present, or the project coordinator. Then of course, the site engineer from the contracting company is present. So here during this meeting, they discuss the progress of the project, that how much work has been completed, if there is any kind of delay or not, the work is being done according to the provided norms and specifications or not. So all of these details are documented, and coordination and communication is done within all the teams. Then we have the test reports. Now it is the responsibility of the site engineer to see to it that different types of test reports are being documented and submitted whenever and wherever needed. This can be any kind of test that is it may include the different machines or equipments. It may include the testing of different materials, of different services, anything. Measurement. Now, different kinds of measurements are needed all over the site. May it be a civil engineer, electrical engineer, or the electrical engineer. So for a civil engineer, of course, the different types of measurements are done for the execution. Say foundation work is being done, or we are up to the superstructure level, then casting is done. So measurements are taken by the team constantly. Then for the electrical engineers, they measure the entire site for laying out the cables. So they fill up the RDS and also provide us with the cable schedule. So what kind of cable will be needed or will be used, and this length of cable will be used. Then for the mechanical contractors, they will use the different types of pipes and all those measurements. Okay. Then we have the billing part. So the site engineer will keep up with the billing also. So their billing is specific to the contract side. So the billing will be done that this kind of material has been used till date at the site, or this specific lot of equipments are used. This is the kind of service that we use, says the civil engineers contracting company. Then this JCB was used for these hours and that. So all of that will be documented. The next we have the bill passing, material reconciliation, and handover of the work. Now the billing that is done needs to be passed from certain authorities that are included or that are a part of the project. It's not like you just made the bill and you will be paid up front. You need to prove the amount of bill that you have raised. So the bill passing is done. This is the role of a site engineer. Then material reconciliation, as we talked about. Then the handover of the work. Once the work or the job is completed, then the handing over process takes place. Handing over is can be done either area wise or building wise, depending upon the project. So the site it is the responsibility of the site engineer to submit to the client all the keys and all the keys of the locks and the site that we are dealing with. Then different types of manuals, that is the operating manuals of all the equipments and machineries that are involved. So all of these documents are submitted to the PMC team, and then the handing over is completed. Okay. Next, we have the client purchase engineer role. Now, the purchase engineer from the client side is a subset, has a subset or similar role as the purchase engineer that we discussed in the Now we have the client purchase engineer role. Now, what is the role of a purchase engineer here? So firstly, study of the technical specifications, BOQ, and tenders. Okay. Now the purchase engineer firstly analyzes that what kind of material will be needed, what kind of services we have to provide during the run of the project. So he or she will map out the entire plan as far as possible and prepare a schedule for the different materials at different points of time. So a study of technical specifications is needed, that this quality of material has to be ordered, this quality of material has to be stored. So it will be done from the BOQ and the tender that is provided by the client and the engineering design consultant. Next is the tender participation, documentation and pre-bid meeting. Now this is the role of a purchase engineer, that before the contractor has taken the job, there is a pre-bid meeting for where the different contractors attend the meeting that the client has rolled out or rolled out some kind of tender. So if there are any questions or queries that the purchase engineer has or that the contractor has, so the purchase engineer will attend this meeting and clear it out with the engineering consultant or the client. They will participate in filling out the tender or filling out the rates for scoring a project. Then they will also be a part of the documentation right from the start. So different kinds of documents that are needed during the entire project, right, starting from taking up the job until the entire handing over takes place. So the purchase engineer is involved in all of that. The next role he has is payment CFM tracking, the client inflow and sub agencies outflow. Now CFM is cash flow monitoring or cash flow management. So a contractor side purchase engineer always tracks the payment that is being done or that is being received. Okay, so the receiving side will be the client. So we have the client inflow and the outflow will be for the sub agencies. Now no contractor has of course all the services in house, so they will be appointing some different kinds of agencies that are called the sub agencies. Say we take an example that a contractor has taken up the finishes work for some certain site. Okay, they are not doing the structure part, they are doing the finishes. Now the finishes includes many things like tiling, laying out the tiles or laying out the carpet and flooring, then paint job, then plastering. So all the different agencies that are needed. Now all these services that I mentioned are done by different agencies. So the contractor will appoint all these agencies and they will be working together under this one contractor. So the role of purchase engineer is to track the different stages of the payment as decided with the client, that we need 20% advance, then 30% will be done after this much work is completed. So receiving the payment from the client and then doing back-to-back payment to the sub agencies that are involved. Then next role is the site material requirements and purchase planning. Now for this site material requirement, the purchase engineer stays in constant coordination with the site engineer from the contractor side as well as the store manager. Now as I mentioned, the site does not have specific hours, whereas the purchase engineering team works as the corporate side, so they do have fixed office hours. So they plan out the entire thing or the material requirements such that the work at the site is not interrupted, or they try their best that the work is not interrupted at any point of time. So they plan out the different stages at which certain materials will be needed and order the materials as such. Now some materials are such that they can be used only after specific testings are done. So those materials are ordered in such a way that the time for the material testing is calculated, and then the material arrives at the time when it is needed. Also one more thing to keep in mind is the storage. Now they need to coordinate with the store manager constantly so that not over ordering or under ordering of any material is done. Say the contractor is given some specific store at the site or specific space for storing his materials. Now if some material is already stored there and we order a bulk of another material, then we don't have any space to store it. So the purchase engineer has the job to coordinate with the site engineer as well as the store manager and then see to it that enough space is available or not. Next, we have the material equipment FAT and delivery at site. FAT means the factory acceptance test. Now, we have discussed this and the client's team, I'll explain it to you again. Now, the purchase engineer here also coordinates with the engineering design consultant, the project coordinator from the client side, and the site engineer when the purchase of any kind of material or equipment is needed. So there are some heavy equipments, heavy process equipments that are provided from the client side. So what the job of the purchase engineer here is that they coordinate the entire meet of all these agencies with the vendor and suppliers. Now some equipments are so heavy and so costly that any defect is not allowed once they are received at the site. So what the purchase engineer do is they arrange the meeting at the vendor or supplier site, even if it is in a foreign country. So the team or coordinators will fly from our country to their site and do a FAT, the factory acceptance test. So they will test the entire equipment at the vendor site only and see to it that it fits all the requirements and specifications that are provided by the client. And after that test is done, they will take the delivery at the site. So the purchase engineer here also coordinates that the proper delivery is taken at the site or not, and the delivery is taken at the right time or not. Then lastly, we have store management, material reconciliation, and defect liability. Now, I already explained the store management and material reconciliation. So, talking about the defect liability, now certain services and machines have different defect liability periods. So, the purchase engineer here documents all the guarantees and warranties that are provided by the vendors or suppliers. So, if some kind of operating liability rises up or some kind of manufacturing defect rises up in the equipment, then if the equipment is still under the defect liability period, then they can surely contact the vendor or supplier for the required repairs. Okay, so this is the role of the purchase engineer. Okay, this was a long one. So in summation, the main roles of a purchase engineer are that they need to study the different specifications, BOQs, and tenders in order to plan the different materials and different equipments at the site. They take part in the pre-bid meetings for scoring a contract. They track the different payment situations from the client and also to the sub-agencies. Then they coordinate with the site engineers and the store management for material purchase and planning. They coordinate with the vendors, design consultants, client coordinators, and site engineers for the FAT of materials or equipments and their delivery at specific time. And finally, they look after the material reconciliation and the defect liability if needed. Next, we have the contracting company site support team role. Now, the main motive or the main role of this team is just to assist the contracting company team that we discussed earlier, that is the site engineer team and the purchase team. Okay, so what their role is that they act as site supervisors, as technicians, and as storekeepers. So we'll take an example. Suppose we are talking about a civil contracting company and it is a big site. Okay, so at in one site, at one place, we are digging up for the laying of foundation. At one stage, the foundation work is over and we are doing the superstructure. At one place, the building has been constructed and we are dealing with the finishes. So these are very different stages of just one civil contractor's project. So the main role of the site and supervisor or technician or storekeeper here is to coordinate with all these different locations in one site and see whatever they need. If they need some kind of labor, if they need some mason, if they need some skilled labor, that is for some special work, if needed, they need some kind of material. So basically, they act as assistants to the site engineers and the project coordinators from the contracting company. The next role is manpower management, labor cards, and safety protocols. Now, manpower management is a very tricky subject when it comes to a contracting company, and a very crucial one. So, a proper management system is needed. For example, a very large site is going on and some 400 or say 500 laborers are working per day. So, a lot of manpower management is needed, that all the laborers are arriving at time on site, they are starting the work at the given time, their safety is being maintained or not. Then they also maintain the labor cards, that is, they do their attendance and pay at daily wages if decided, or pay weekly or bi-weekly. So all these things are done by the support team. Now, yes, safety protocols are to be maintained very strictly. Hard hats and safety vests, all of these are provided to all the laborers, and this is the role of the support team to look after that the different safety protocols are maintained or not. Now, in smaller sites or small projects, the site support team role only will look after the safety protocols. But if the site is very large or it is a high scale project, then a special safety engineer will be appointed for the site. Okay. Next, we have the work execution assistance and labor colony maintenance. Now, medium scale to large scale projects need a very high number of laborers per day. So we can't go to the market and appoint laborers every day. So a fixed team of laborers is working there every day for the entire project. So they also need a place to live. So a labor colony is built just besides the site, and there are different requirements, that is, the water they need, food, light, gas, everything they need. All this is supported and all this is provided by the site support team. So one of their role is the maintenance of the entire labor colony. Second is the work execution assistance. Now, in the first point we discussed that they assist in different execution stages as and when needed. Okay. Next, we have the power or standby power and water supply arrangement. Now, the site work, as we know, does not have any definite working hours. So, depending upon the urgency and the stage at which the site is, the work can require very high amount of load or power at one point, and they might not need it at another. So it is the role of the support team to see to it that constant power is being provided to the site. So if we are doing the concreting work at night, for example, then it is their role to see that proper lighting is done in the entire site, or specifically in the concreting area. Then a proper power supply is there, that is, if we need a DG set, then DG sets are installed, then the fuel that is needed in the DG set is there on the site or not. They also look after that constant water supply is being done during the concreting work. Then drinking water is available for all the laborers and site engineers that are there on the site. So all of these things are taken care of by the site support team. Next, we have the construction machinery and equipment maintenance. Now, any construction site includes a plethora of different machines and equipments used from day-to-day basis. Now, they are used very roughly for sure. So they need constant and high amounts of maintenance. So we can't just go to a repairing shop every time equipment breaks down. So the support team either learns how to repair or maintain these small faults. Of course, if the machine is completely broken down, then we need to repair it. But some minor faults, the support team helps us with that, and either they arrange for the laborers who can do that. So there are many equipments like a breaker, then we have the vibrating or compacting machine, then we say a JCB is working there, so a JCB maintenance person will be there. All these equipments need some constant maintenance, so it is their role to see to it that these machines are working properly. Then we have the store material loading, unloading, stacking, issue and stock. So the store material is ordered and managed by the site engineers and purchase engineers, but some materials have some specific rules or specific norms that they require while storage. So it is the responsibility of the site support team to look after that proper loading is done, proper unloading is done, that minimum breakage is there. For example, we are loading and unloading the bricks, then they see to it that say 1 or 2% of breakage is there for the bricks, so we are not handling it very roughly, so that a large amount of bricks break down. So all of these things, then stacking of these bricks or cement bags is done. Then they look after the issuing of the different materials and also stocking and piling of them. So all in all, we saw the different roles that are performed by the site support team. So in one word, they act as the assistants to the site engineers and the entire contracting company team. Okay. Now next, we have, so this brings us to the end of the contracting company team roles. Okay. So what did we see? We saw the different roles that are performed by the site engineers from the contracting side. We saw the different roles performed by the purchase engineers. And finally, we saw the roles that are performed by the site support team role. Now, I just want to add some more things, that the contracting company takes the projects in generally two manners. That is, they either take the project in a turnkey contract, or either it is done in the EPC format, that is engineering, procurement and construction. Okay. In government project, the contractor does the turnkey, except the designing and architecture, while in the corporate projects, the civil, electrical and mechanical contractors are different, and the client purchases the high side machines. So this is the general format that we see in the different sites in our country. Okay. So this brings us to the end of the contracting team roles in a mega project.
Hokidemi, shaping professionals for a better future. Hokidemi is aiming to be the world's largest learning platform for engineers and architects. Hokidemi will help you to develop your skills in project design and management, to become team leaders and project managers in mega structure projects. Hokidemi provides learning by high-quality video lectures in all sectors, like power, industrial, commercial, institutional, residential, etc., based on 1,000-plus real projects done by our group on Hokidemi.com. To study in detail with books, drawings, articles, and catalogs, visit Hokicart.com. Please like, share, and subscribe our channel to stay updated on our latest contents.